Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here, and today we're going to show you how to program a Honeywell 5800 PIR-RES residential wireless motion detector. This is the most popular Honeywell motion detector available. It's the one that's included with all of the Honeywell wireless security system kits, but it is able to be paired to a 2 gig Go Control because the Go Control wireless receiver works on the same 345 megahertz radio frequency range that a Honeywell system uses, or Honeywell sensor uses. So the 2 gig panel will work with 2 gig sensors, and also without needing anything else, it will work with Honeywell sensors. So we're gonna show you how to go ahead and program your 5800 PIR-RES to your 2 gig Go Control. Just like with all of our system programming, we can go through security, menu, toolbox, or the same option is a hotkey, Go Control. We do our installer code 1561 and we hit system configuration. Now we're on Q1 with a 2 gig panel. If you've done Honeywell programming, this is a bit different. It's question-based programming. Question number one is for your wireless sensors. The 2 gig Go Control supports up to 48 wireless sensors, and we have not yet programmed any wireless sensors to our panel. So we're on available slot number one, and we're gonna go ahead and choose that option by hitting the down arrow. Now we're on a sensor one type. Just like on a Honeywell system, this is the response type field, where you're telling the system what device are we programming and how should this device respond. With a motion detector, we want it on in away mode, off in stay mode. So there's two available response types that will do that. One is 04 interior follower, and one is 10 interior with delay. If your motion looks directly at a door that's programmed with entry exit 1, which means it's a door you use when it's open, when the system is armed, then you need to have interior with delay. That means this motion will not activate an alarm without an entry delay anytime it's triggered. So even if the door is not open and someone axes through your wall or breaks in through a roof or somehow gets in without violating any sensor first, then the motion won't sound the alarm right away. It would wait until the programmed entry delay period times out, and then you would have your alarm. So interior delay is when you have it looking directly at a door programmed with delay. However, if it's not looking directly at one of those doors, interior follower is a more secure and better option. And this is the option that most wireless motions will use. Interior follower means it's going to be an instant alarm. As soon as the intruder passes in front of the motion, it will be an alarm right away. However, follower, that means if an entry exit zone is triggered first, it will then follow the delay. So let's say this is in your living room and you enter your front door, you round a hallway, you pass through your living room to get to your keypad. If this only did a full alarm at all times with no delay, you'd have a false alarm every time you come home. With interior follower, the door opening is not triggering the device, but once you walk through the living room, the panel, because it was put into delay mode by the front door, then the motion knows to follow that same delay. So you would not have an alarm as you pass through the motion to get to the keypad. So most motions get interior follower. Motions that look directly at a door that's a delayed door, then they don't have time to follow because the door opening is actually triggering the motion. So there's where you would use zone type 10 or sensor one type 10, which is interior with delay. So we're gonna go follower. And it's asking for the equipment type, which is motion. And if we hit the down arrow again, they actually want the equipment code. And that's the specific model number of the device we're using. So if we scroll past the 2 gig stuff, we get to Honeywell stuff, which is HW. And you could put HW PIR 5890, even though it's a 5800 PIR-RES. They haven't updated their equipment codes with some of the newer sensors. So you could do existing motion to call it more generic. Since it's not technically a 5890, or because this operates very similar to a 5890, you can go ahead and just choose HW PIR 5890. For me, I don't ever like to tell someone in the back end that the device is something that it's not, so I'm just going to choose existing motion detector. We hit the down arrow, and now we have to enter our serial number. Serial number is on the back of the motion. If we were to pop the cover on the motion, it's on a sticker on the inside as well. We can type our serial number in, or my personal preference and what I always urge our users to do is to do shift followed by learn. And now we're waiting for an RF sensor transmission. I have already pulled my battery out because on the 5800 PIR res, it's got a unique feature to preserve the battery. If the system is disarmed and the sensor is faulted, it puts the sensor to sleep for 3 full minutes and it won't wake back up until that 3 minute period expires and then it's ready to fault again. That's so you don't drain the battery as you walk throughout your house. However, because of that, it can make it kind of hard to learn it in by faulting the device, because now we're waiting, is it sleeping? Is it not sleeping? Waiting 3 minutes, it takes some time. If we insert the battery fresh, as if it's a brand new install, you can see this light come on. And this LED will flash at you for a few seconds until it goes silent. Then the unit is actually on. This is called the power on stabilization period. And it's kind of stabilizing the PIR, passive infrared technology, on the inside of the sensor. Now that it's, once it's done with that sequence, by faulting or waving our hand in front of the motion, we should be able to auto learn the serial number into the zone. So we're just gonna wait for this period to time out. I believe it's about a minute where we have to wait here. Now that the LED has stopped, the next fault, just me moving very slightly, triggered it, and we can see 0463852. When doing auto enrollment on a system that has other sensors in the house, it's very important that we verify that this number is the same as this number. If someone in the house went to go open a door, they could jump in ahead of the motion and program a different serial number, and we would have an issue because now we think it's programmed, but it's not. As long as we know we're the right serial number, we know that it's this device and this device only that we're programming. We're faulting it as I move it. That's why you keep seeing these transmissions received. Every single time we're seeing the same serial number, that means no one else in the house is tripping anything and the motion should be good. So if we hit OK here, we're back to the sub question for entering the serial number, and we can advance by hitting the down arrow. Once we hit the down arrow, it's asking, is this a brand new motion or is this an existing motion? You can see here we have screw holes for mounting. This device has been used on a prior installation because we had this Lynx touch panel before we had this Go control. So we're going to go ahead and choose that it's an existing device. That goes to the that goes to your monitoring company so that they know, is this a device they sold you or is it a device that you had previous? Helps them when troubleshooting the device. So it's always good to let them know the right sequence or the right status of the device there. Now we have loop number. Any motion detector that's a 5800 PIR-res or RES should be programmed as loop number one. And if we hit the down arrow, we have a dial delay. And this would tell the system to hold alarm transmissions from this device for the preset dial delay period until that period times out, then it sends the alarm to the central station. We always recommend disabling this device so that alarms from this device go to the central station right away. Hit the down arrow and we're on the Construct RF Sensor 1 voice descriptor. This is our living room motion. So to do that, we're gonna go ahead and hit insert living off of our voice descriptor sheet, which is the available words in the 2 gig Go control library. We can go ahead and see that living is 133 and then hit insert. Room is 187. Insert again. Motion detector is 147. You can continue to put up to a total of 5 words. If 2 words are showing in one slot, one highlighted slot, that's only counting for 1 word. So we could still give it 2 more descriptors. But we only have 1 motion in the living room, so this descriptor is as good as we need it to be. We hit the down arrow to lock it in. This is on the back of your quick programming guide that comes with the 2 gig Go control, and we also have this information on our website, alarmgrid.com. So now we're asked, will this sensor report? Report references central station monitoring. Do we want alarms from this device to go to the central station? Typically, if it's a protection zone, yes, You want it to be enabled if you're monitoring, so that alarms from the motion will go to your central station for monitoring purposes. Finally, supervision. Always, when using wireless protection zones, you want to have it supervised. That will make sure that low battery or range issues from the motion will be reported by the panel, so that you know in advance that you have to change a battery or relocate a sensor or make a change to your environment, so that you have a good wireless transmission between your sensor and your panel. Hit the down arrow to lock that in. Chime is the next question. We don't normally recommend doing chime on a motion, especially with the battery saver feature. That chime wouldn't even work really well without the battery saver feature, or even with it, you're just going to hear annoying chimes as you walk throughout your house. So that's why we don't normally recommend chime on a motion. If you hit the down arrow, we're on our summary screen. We can verify that all the programming we did is right. We have an interior follower, so the motion is turned off automatically in stay mode and active in away mode. It is a motion detector. It's an existing motion detector with a serial number and a loop number of number one. Our dial delay is disabled so that alarms go through to the central station right away. We have our good voice descriptor, living room motion detector. And if we hit the down arrow again, we can see we've enabled monitoring reporting. We have an enabled low battery and supervision or range supervision. And finally, we've disabled chime. If we hit skip and end and then exit, we've locked in our 5800 PIR-res programming to our 2 gig Go control. The panel goes dark because it reboots anytime you make programming changes, save them, and exit. And after a few seconds, we're going to hear disarm, not ready, or disarm, ready to arm.
System disarmed, ready to arm.
And after a few more seconds, we're going to see our screen. And assuming we're still in the walk test period, which is 10 minutes after you first put the battery in, when we wave our hand in front of it, we can see the guy in the house, and we can see living room motion detector open. And that would let us know, okay, you're not going to be able to arm it until the motion stops. Now we know we've properly programmed our Honeywell 5800 PIR-RES to our 2 gig Go control. We hope you've enjoyed this video. We invite you to subscribe to our channel. And if you have questions on programming your Honeywell wireless 5800 PIR-RES, please email support@alarmgrid.com.